Today we are diving into the world of Spring configuration, but before we jump in, let's talk about a cool feature that makes Spring Boot development super convenient and, in my opinion, magical. And that cool feature is auto configuration. So Spring Boot comes with a lot of auto configuration policies, and we can see that when we add dependencies to our project. Like when we add Spring Boot Starter Web to our application, then it comes with an embedded Tomcat server. And when we run our application, then the embedded Tomcat server start to listen on port 8080, right? So that is very convenient for us. We didn't need to configure anything regarding the port. Spring Boot automatically configuring that for us. But what if we want to change the port? What if we are running two separate applications from the same machine? Then we have to change our port, because two applications cannot run on the same port on the same host. So in that case, we have to change the port. And same goes for Spring Data JPA. When we add Spring Data JPA to our application, then all the configuration for database connection is automatically configured to our application. We just need to provide the username and password. So that brings us to the main topic of this video, which is Spring configurations. So how we can override the auto configuration provided by Spring Boot? In order to do that, we have a file under our resource folder called application.properties or application.yml. Both is for same purpose. The syntax for the file is just different. Okay, so I'm continuing with application.properties file, which is a key value format with equal sign, where the first part is the key and then equal sign and the value. Let's say we want to host our application to port 8081. Then what we have to do is we have to set the port for servlet container to 8081. We can do that by setting server.port to 8081. So now if we run our application once again, then our application is listening to 8081. Now let's see how the application.yml file would look like if we want to follow the YML syntax. So I'm renaming the file to application.yml. This is the format for YML. Actually, Spring Boot support a lot of configuration, which we can learn from the official documentation of Spring Boot here. Here we can have categorized properties value. Like if we want to have web properties, then this is for GraphQL. If we want to have server properties, then server.address. Different type of properties here. This is the server.port, which we are using for our example. Okay, so this application.yml file support two kind of properties. One is which I have just shown predefined in the Spring documentation. Another one is our custom value. If we want to have some value which we want to have configurable in our application, then we can put that in our YML file. Like we want to have a property called, we can access this value in our application with annotation called property. Okay, so this YML file or properties file also support different type of profiles. Like I can create a separate YML file in the format of application hyphen the name of our profile dot yml or properties, then that will be another profile which we can set from our main application.yml file. So Spring Boot will first look into the application.yml or application.properties file. So if I want to use a separate profile, then I can use this one, spring.profiles.active equal to, let's say, local. Then I have to have a configuration file called application-local.yml, and then I can bring all my configuration from this to this local file. And for our testing, if we put here 8088 and run our server again, then we'll see that our application is running on port 8088. Another way we can access our custom property to our code is writing configuration class. So let's say we have two different value here, my custom value, my custom code, which is Munir. For this we can create a class, and inside the class we can put a annotation called configuration properties, and inside that configuration properties we just have to put my.custom, and it will read all the sub value under that prefix. All the value will be assigned to the appropriate variable defined in the configuration class. So those are different ways we can access value from our YML file. I would like to encourage you to experiment with properties and explore further resource which is available on Spring Boot documentation. I'll refer a link in the video description. So that's all for this tutorial. I'll see you in the next tutorial. Happy coding!